Okay, we're back on this thing today. We're going to do the eyes. And I've lightly penciled in there what I think would be best. So let me just pencil these. We want him kind of squinty-eyed. And we want him to look off to his right, our left. So we'll draw our lines in here. Just like that. I learned something from a friend of mine, and that is when you turn your eyes to one side or the other, the eye protrudes more than it does if you look straight forward. Now, I didn't know that, but I know it now. So learn all kinds of things. So I think that looks pretty good. So that's what we're going to do. As soon as I get my glove on here. Okay, we're going to start with this eye. And also, if you notice how this comes down from this point, it goes down just a smidgen. This one over here should be doing the same thing. Just a smidgen. Not much. See, one thing we're going to have to do is even up these bags, but we'll do that here in a minute. So I'm going to do this eye first. So I'm just going to go directly in there. All the way out. This time I'm going to tip my knife up just a bit. Like that. And I'm going to take that chip out. That a little deeper. Well, that didn't take long, did it? All right, now we'll do the other one. Make sure we get our lines lined up right. Watch out for those things. You want that corner to be a little deeper to give you a little shadow effect there. Same thing over here on this side. Okay, now we're going to do the lower lash real shallow. Don't try to do this with the point of your knife or you're going to end up going too deep. And do it with the blade. And make sure your knife's extremely sharp. If you don't, it'll crumble on you. All right, got that there. Remember I said that when you turn your eyes, how the eye protrudes more in the direction you're looking than it does in the other direction? Well, that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to indicate that. First, I'm taking that out of there. And we're going to do that by going a little deeper here. Same thing here. Now I look at the shadow effect, and that looks pretty good. Now, what we want to do is we want to get this lower lash to curl in underneath that upper one about right there. And the same thing over here. That one. Not lash, bag. Let's say bag. Just take that out there. Looks good. When you're doing these lines, always keep your knife at a real shallow angle so you don't end up with real harsh lines. Give him a frown line right here. Sometimes you can do it just by curling your knife up. Other times you have to do it. looks good. I'm going to do that line there again. Good. Now let's take this one out here. Another. Have the sun all day. These guys get these wrinkles. Good. We're going to take our knife and above the eye, we're not going to do it, we're going to curve it away from that. Like that. Right on the direction of the grains. It's kind of hard. So you want just a little shadow effect there. A deeper part right there. Looks good. Learn to use shadows to help you carve. You can see the areas you need to work on just by looking at the shadows. He's looking really good. Okay, what we want to do now is give him a couple of wrinkle up your forehead, you'll always notice there's a little itty area right there in the center. You always get that little itty area. So you can see it right there. See it? And these you don't really want to cut into it to get that wrinkle. You just want to spin it out with your knife. Kind of bleed them out when you get in towards the center. This one run right on across. The higher they go up on the head, the more relaxed they become. Don't like that one right there. That's going to be. So that about does it for the face. And I think we've really got us a nice looking face there. That is a neat looking character, I think. Okay, so the next thing, I know we still have to do the hair, but there's nothing to worry about. Next thing is the bust. The lower part of the body, and I was just screwing around with this sheet of paper that I drew this on. See what I come up with. So we're going to put a knot here, and his neckerchief's going to come around. And I'm just going to have a couple of ties. I'm just going to have a vest which comes down here, and then these arms which come around here. And these buttons. I like that right there. So that's going to be kind of. Anyway, you can see basically what it'll look like. You'll be looking off over to the side like that. Okay? You want to keep his knot on this side away from his face, because we want everything running right up to his face. Everything to draw into his face. That's composition. And we'll work on this in the next video. Hopefully we'll get out a 3-inch block and move on from there. So until next time, I'll talk to you later.